Thank you very much, Professor Bhandari. This is something which is very close to me. Actually, people who take fellowship under me always tell that it is just not surgery. If you think you're going to learn surgery, then you have the toughest time of your life. If academics and this doesn't go, everybody says that either you be a good surgeon, you can't do academics. You're in private where you're running behind the patients, the list. But I always believe the other way around. If academics and these don't do together, it's just perishing. We just keep doing something tabulation which has no value. This is something very close to me, and I strongly replicate it not only in this fellowship program, in the other Manipal University fellowship program. I'll try to put few thoughts and improvement what we can suggest to the fellowship. So when a fellow comes to us, or when a fellow is placed under us, they just think that anatomy, surgical skill, I master the technique, I'm just go. Is that all you think, what we think? I definitely believe this is just 1% of the entire fellowship program. If somebody thinks this is what, they don't have to come to us, they don't have to come through the Vattikuti Foundation, spend phenomenal effort to do that. That can be acquired anywhere. That's not going to lead us anywhere. I went through, when I preparing this presentation, a lot of academic foundation program from UK, and what is the sequence we have in UK system, in other system, how to actually take them graded through. We know that we always say publish, perish. People say, oh, you publish in India, you don't become a professor. It's like there's no academic growth, it's only in Western world. If you don't audit your own work and do academics with that, you will never know what you have. You're like a frog in a well, and I keep thinking this is the best and I'm going to follow this, I keep doing this. What is my first year of robotic and what is my 10th year? There is no difference, and that's a disaster, and I believe that that is a professional suicide, both to science community, to the student, for self. So there are various steps in fellowship training. What I will confine myself is to the Vattikuti Robotic Foundation. Very few people ever do data entry real time. I make it a rule. I become a dictator to my fellow. Data entry same today, same day it should be done. If you don't capture a good data, you can never audit. You doesn't know where you're wrong. You can't think laterally and you can't do anything. If my fellow doesn't do a publication every 3 months, I strongly recommend Professor Bhandari that at the completion, the certificate should be given at least when during the training period, under the mentor they posted, in the work they're doing, a manuscript should have been submitted at least to a journal, which should not be done. Believe me, they can do many publications. The effort itself is more important than actual publication. I'm not interested, got published. The effort of uploading should be made mandatory. And most of the people, you know, don't even clip their online video. In Delhi, they'll be doing very good work, in Mumbai. But remember, this is a pan-India. No one surgeon is good. I voluntarily tell my fellows that you must go and observe other people. There are many other right way they're doing it. And what works for you is different. There's no ego in this. So there has to be app which is formed by our group, which is for fellows. See, imagine at the end of the day, all the fellows, if there are 20 fellows today, they go home evening and they have looked at something. What I learned today in 1 minute. So you don't say that, oh, I did one hysterectomy, I did one hysterectomy, everybody is doing. Today I learned that this particular movement which was done by mentor or by me made a difference. Imagine all the 30 fellows have their own app and they just say what I learned today for 1 minute. Believe me, that can change even the mentor who is doing it. This is something which is very, very, very easy. I see at the end of the day, two of my fellows come and say, sir, you did this procedure. This is how, if you had done it, would have been good. Tomorrow I do that and imagine that doesn't die with me. There are so many things which we learn from everybody. So I strongly recommend we must do an online video of only the fellows who do it and they must share what they did. So if you look back, academics, program, all, if they don't go together, nothing is going to happen. So these are the steps I have put it. For want of time, I'll not expand. I'll just go through what is at each step at a good level, what is part of the academics you must do. Either an institution provides a medical data entry for this fellowship, because there's already a fellowship data entry, high quality from foundation. Those which is not there, they must start. We start with a logbook, but we should not end at logbook. We must start a digital logbook of every case you enter. When a fellow came to me, two of them, they told, sir, you already published everything, esophagus 4, thyroid, there is nothing left for us this term. I say that, don't think you want to do a rare thing to do it. A common thing, what can be improved itself is different. And don't think same way. Because a procedure card came from intuitive, don't think, oh, that's the way to do. Or somebody has been done 1,000 Whipples with this laparoscopy, so that's what. Do a lateral thinking. I'll give an example of lateral thinking, which two of my fellows, I stimulated for them to do that. So this is something very important for us to go ahead and do that. And there has to be a journal club among the fellows, across. Imagine every week, on this day, there's a journal club between the 30 of the fellows. They are the most talented pool who are dedicated and they are there. And if they don't do that, in addition to 1 minute, what I learned in this week, they must have a journal club among themselves to do that. See, because a mentor can just show the direction. Don't think we can spoon feed them. You give a knowledge, show the direction, and they innovate, and they can come back and teach the mentor and foundation for us to actually go ahead how to do that. I'll tell you the example of alternate thinking. This was postulated by two of my fellows. They told, sir, you keep doing, you say your technique is good. What is the proof? So I told them, next 50 cases, you do a randomized trial. One case you do mine, one case you do this. And don't even involve me. And the other person documents. 1 month later, sit with my statistics, come back. They give this result. Sir, yours this one, this many percent clash. Intuitive procedure card, this many flash, this many, this many. This is how you put a port. Then they told, do this modification, 100% you're fine. This is called lateral thinking. They thought in the same regular simple procedure. You don't have to do 100 esophagectomy, 100 Whipple's or 100 rectum to make a paper. Imagine the most important paper are the one which are basic in the common area which makes practice change rather than one tough surgery which we see in a conference, come clap, go back and none of them replicate. No use of doing something which very few people can at the tip of the pyramid do it. If you devise any academics which doesn't make a difference in 90% of the center across the world, 90% of the surgeon who can reproduce at 90% level, it is never going to stand test of time. So this is something which is very important that you have to go through this particular training. So if you don't have your own database, please put it in MS Excel, then go back to SSP software and come back. So I always say at the end of the day, don't lock your locker room unless that day's registry online system is entered. You'll be surprised if you collect the data, what happens. Nicely, foundation has already given this record keeping database. But every disease is not blessed. You know, currently we have for 5 or 6, so they go and enter. All you need to do as a mentor and student is every 6 months or 3 months you sit and audit it, you'll be surprised to know, oh, my leak rate is 1%. Or my leak rate is 5%. So what should I do next? So this is something which is what is important. Second, every fellow when he starts must do a learning curve of himself with him. Remember, the learning curve is not just for the mentor because the docking time, moving time. So now the new system has changed. New fellow has come. So you have joined them. I always recommend every fellow who start their program, be it Euro, Gynec, Onco, wherever you are, please do your Kusum curve. You'll be surprised to know. This was a curve given by my fellow, by my statistics, who told me, sir, in 12th case of your gynae onco, we break even in terms of quality and time. I surprised, I never had this value. So then he went on to publish this particular area and then such came. On the contrary, I always thought I mastered in robotic rectum. When they put my learning curve, they told, sir, it took 50th case to master everything. Imagine if everybody do with your fellow this. I recommend every fellow, please do this with you. You'll be surprised to know what you can learn there to go back and do. Second, there is no thesis in the fellowship which is mandated like university, but take it as a project. Do at least 2 data entry, 2 paper and convert it into a paper and assign it. Remember, if you don't do lateral thinking and analyze, I'll tell you one. Sachin came back from Delhi and he told, sir, everything I have done. I just told one of my fellow, I'll post under you. We had a ultrasound tail puro, now we don't have. We just thought that we'll just see what is the warm ischemic time. So imagine if you just analyze what difference it made in warm ischemic time, we can make a different paper. Did we remove more kidney than required tissue? So that lateral thinking is required. So we don't have to do something new. What everybody is doing the same, so there is nothing new paper. Please think laterally and make a area. Second is, we must add a research. Research didn't have to be going into lab and doing some molecular research or some infrared or ice. Do a research as a fellow in the given scenario, in the patient and with the people what you are. I will tell you that, you know, Intuitive is so famous for doing this bowel perfusion. How the lateral thinking of research one of my fellow, two of the fellows did. They just told, sir, if you don't use ICG, extra bowel you remove, so there will be diarrhea. So there is a rectal syndrome. If you don't use bone anastomosis, will leak. I told them, then you just do like this. Without ICG, we complete the procedure. We decide all 4 where we cut the bowel. Now we'll put ICG, we'll see. So this is a paper which will be presented. You will be seeing that 76% of the time, we would have knocked off extra bowel and caused malabsorption and diarrhea to the patient. 7% of the time, it would have leaked. Only 15% we were right. This is a lateral thinking in the given scenario paper coming out for us to do that. So data analysis, putting your learning curve, putting the Kusum curve, mandated attend RSC and your conference and making a publication. And we should not allow them to travel abroad just to present unless they have submitted a manuscript for you to do. And we have to encourage. And have your own WhatsApp group. Don't flood it personal message, but share what you learned today which others can look it up. And maintain the logbook very good. This is a logbook of my fellow. So you can see that when I look it, I see, oh, you have done 10 as a sensual surgeon, 20 as this. So this month you've done less. So I know where to stand. You can go back and audit and do your publication mandatory and discuss all the recent trials happening in robotics for you. So this is very important that what we know, I will not know from urology. There are a lot to pick up from urology and other people. So the fellows should also do this on their own group. Look at the trials and then publish all the papers. You can do this. And do an HKT video of fellows. Don't come and show your boss video. Do your video on what you learned. That is more easy. You know, I can learn what mistake you made and how you picked it up. And academic forum discussion among the student to the group. You must do this. Is something very, very important. And then we spare it the online library of fellows alone as your own. So these are all the publications which our fellows did during their program, which will be the most important thing. Second, cost factor. Imagine in your own institution, without robot, normal laparoscopy and open surgery, what is the cost? And you put direct and indirect cost. So if you do the direct, this is a good paper. So to come to my conclusion, if you don't publish, you perish. If academics is not there, just use the foundation money, come learn surgery and put a tag of robotic note. Data entry, auditing, logbook, putting your learning curve, knowing your custom curves, and then various research project, publishing it, and finally the hallmark would be to do a Cochrane review for you. Remember, all students are not same. Everybody's needs is different. Even every parent knows that within you, you have a 2 or 3 child, 8 child is different. So it is for us from foundation, mentor, and also to give a feedback from the fellows to understand what is that modification we need to do. And it's a 3-way program, not only life with foundation, 90% of it lies with mentor and the fellows to do that. So thank you very much. And this is something very important. We should try to resolve and persist in the same thing what we go ahead and not try to reinvent the wheel. Thanks.